I love to see these stories because it's such a reminder of how big God is. You know, sometimes we let our problems overwhelm us and we forget that God is the author of it all. And what a word from His mouth changes things. His ear is bent to hear your request. And so today we want to read some of the prayer requests that you've sent in. We want to pray for you. We want your faith to be encouraged by Grayson's story as we believe for your needs and stand with you for your needs. This is, Gordon, someone who's asking for prayer for healing of severe congestive heart failure. Someone else saying, I have esophageal cancer. Someone saying, I need healing from COPD, and then asking for a marriage restoration and deliverance from generational sins of Satanism.
Oh. Here's one: healing of extreme gout in the hands and feet, healing from Parkinson's disease, healing from stage 3 melanoma, and then God to provide a job in 6 months, unemployed and trying to pay for 2 mortgages. Wow. God has an answer. I love that story because I love that God spoke to her. And He says, don't you trust me by now? Haven't I proven myself? Will you rely on me? I've got this. I've got this. You know, God stands amazed sometimes at our unbelief. Start thinking about all the times God saw you through. How many times has He rescued you? How many times has He forgiven you? How many times has He set you free? Has He changed? Is He the same yesterday, today, and forever? Has He changed? Has His love changed? Has something changed with Him? No. No. No matter what the obstacle you're facing, God is able. He's seen you through before. He'll see you through again. All you have to do is believe and trust in Him. And that wonderful couple, they trusted in Him, and they prayed, and they got an answer. If you're wondering how big God is, go out at night, take a look at the stars, look at that great expanse, and just marvel at that. Scientists tell us now that you can travel at the speed of light for 15 billion years, and you won't get to the end of that. Now realize that God made all of that by speaking a single word. He spoke and it came into being. That same God is so concerned about you that He numbers the very hairs on your head. He's got this. He's able to do it. All He's looking for is for us to trust Him, to believe. Those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength. Now, we're going to pray. We have a lot of prayer requests before us, and there are a lot of needs. We've just read a few of them. We're going to pray. We're going to pray to a very big God because He is able to take care of all of these needs. He's able. And we're going to rely on Him and believe His word. He sent His word and healed our disease. He provides all our need according to His riches and glory. He does it all because He wants to. So we're going to agree. Terry and I are going to agree. We've got a great studio audience. They're going to agree with us. We have a great viewing audience. They're going to agree with us. And the Bible says when 2 or more agree touching anything, it shall be done. So let's pray. Let's believe. Now, if you have a need, whether you've written it in to us or not, lay your hand on that need. If it's a financial need, take out a checkbook symbolically. Lay your hands on it. If it's a need for physical healing, lay your hand on that area of the body that needs healing. If it's with your family, find a picture of them. Lay hands on it. And let's believe God. And let's get in contact with Him and let Him speak the word over you and see what happens. Let's pray. Lord, we lift the needs of the audience to You, and we lift those who have written in and requested prayers for healing, requested prayers for family, requested prayers for finances, for jobs. And for those watching right now believing, laying hands on that area of the body that needs healing. Laying hands on a checkbook. Lord, provide. Laying hands on pictures of family members. Lord, deliver, set free, restore, reconcile. Lord, we trust in your unfailing love. The love for us was so great that you gave Jesus, you gave your only begotten Son. How great a love that is. We trust it. We believe in you. Now stretch forth your hand to do miracles, to restore, to heal, to set free, to deliver now, to provide. Lord, you're the answer to every human need. And we lean into you for that answer right now. We come to you in faith, believing. Be healed now. There's someone, you have an infection in your brain. I don't know the name for it, but it's an infection in the membrane surrounding the brain. I don't know what that is, but you do, and God does, and he's healing it right now. You just felt something cool go over your head, and God is touching you. He's healing you. He's restoring you now in Jesus' name. Terry, God's given you something.
Yeah, there's someone else, a brain tumor as well, that's actually visible as it's grown on the outside of your head. And someone, you have a problem with your jaw on the left-hand side. It's like there's a constant aching there. I don't know what your condition is, but God's healing that for you. And someone else, you have something in your throat. I don't know if it's a tumor or what it is, but you feel it when you swallow every time. It's uncomfortable. It causes you not to be able to swallow food well. That's going to go away now in Jesus' name.
There's a man named Tom. You have a torn ACL in your right knee, and God's healing that and restoring it. He's taking away all that pain, all that swelling right now in Jesus' name.
And there's a woman, you found a lump under your arm. You're so fearful about what it is. God's touching and healing that. It's just going to be gone in Jesus' name.
And Lord, we especially come into agreement now for those who are suffering with cancer. And we ask for a complete restoration, that every healthy cell would reproduce normally and be vibrant and full of health, and every cancer cell would die now in Jesus' name. Be removed from their bodies now. You have no power, no authority. You spirit of infirmity, depart now. Set them free, Lord, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. If you've been touched by God, we want to share in your good report. We want to declare his miracles to the people. That's what Psalm 105 tells us to do. Declare his miracles. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. The age of miracles is here and now, because he's here and now. So tell us. Let us know. 1-800-759-0700.